Profit.co supports 7 types of key results that you can use to measure the success of your objectives based on your comfortability level with OKRs. Defining effective key results is crucial for the success of your OKR implementation experience because key results measure the achievement of the objective they're associated with. Each key result type has its own benefit depending on what you're looking to accomplish. Your key result options are percentage tracked, milestone tracked, task tracked, baseline KPI, increase KPI, decrease KPI, and control KPI. Percentage tracked, milestone tracked, task tracked, and baseline KPI are all key results that are trackable. This means their process can be tracked qualitatively, either using a percentage or a series of steps. Increased KPI, decreased KPI, and control KPIs are measurable key results. Their progress is measured using numeric values. To decide which key result type to use, think about if your key result is something that can be measured or tracked. Measurable KPIs could be revenue, a customer satisfaction score, or employee training hours because they can be measured numerically. Examples of trackable key results could be to hire a new manager, develop a sales plan, or publish 10 blog posts. These can be tracked using steps or percentages. Percentage tracked key results are a great option if you have something you can quickly track using a percentage. Milestone tracked key results are good for when you have a key result that needs to be completed in a series of steps. For example, if you want to hire a new manager, there's a process that you need to go through in order for that to be complete. In Profit, you can select a series of steps or milestones that correspond with your key result, or you can create your own. You can also track the progress of a key result by associating tasks to the key result. Based on the number of tasks completed versus the total number of tasks, a percentage value will be calculated. If you don't know the current value of your KPI and you're looking to create a baseline, you can decide what you'd like to change eventually and the steps you're going to take to do so. For example, if you want to establish a customer satisfaction score, you would use a baseline KPI if you do not already have one. Increased KPIs are for when you want to increase a specific value. You might want to increase your revenue, for example, from 1 million to 1.5 million. This would be an increased KPI because you can measure your increase in revenue directly. Decreased KPIs are just like increased KPIs, but you're looking to decrease a specific value. If you want to decrease your new employee turnover rate from 15% to 10%, this is a decrease because you're beginning with a current percentage that you'd like to decrease to a new percentage. The last key result type is control KPI. With control KPIs, you can choose to maintain a KPI within a certain range, set an upper limit or an at most limit, or set a lower or at least limit. If you want to maintain employee training hours, for example, between 20 to 40 hours a year, this would be a maintain control KPI. Maybe you want at most 2 bugs identified per week in production, or to at least publish 3 blog posts per week. These are also examples of control KPIs.